After 12 weeks of non-stop building, Daron now takes time out back in England. A welcome reprieve from sight, but it's not a holiday.
How's that?
Well done, great.
He's here learning the skills he'll need to put the final covering on his roof.
So, now stop there, and then you need to work from here to the middle.
He's trying to build something from a design which is you can do yourself.
You can see. It's welded.
Great.
The only thing where it comes unstuck is when you come to use a product like this, you just cannot do it yourself without the training. Or he can go out and get a contractor to do it, which would cost him X thousands more than he hasn't got. I think that's the key. He's not doing it because he loves it. He's doing it for a financial reason.
By doing the roof himself, Daron can save around £3,000. But he's not the only one learning new skills. Back on site, AD and Sean are being taught how to plaster.
So right in here, I need some more.
And also do a swoop downwards as well.
Been a bit challenging. Been a few moments of swearing, that kind of thing. But we're at the last stage now, so yeah. It's like icing a cake.
By July, work on the roof structure is finished. The pace has been full on, but now their hard work is paying dividends.
It's rather exciting to have a sense of enclosure, isn't it?
It was amazing just seeing when they started putting these struts up. It was just like the whole thing just changed, and suddenly it was a space that you could come into, you know, rather than just some open thing. Yeah, it's really amazing.
Now you've got the ceiling and the roof on it.
Every time I came up here, I was like, gee whiz, you know, and actually the one day I came in here, I was like, I actually cried because it suddenly started feeling like a house and you could kind of imagine where things would be, and it was just like...
You've got a bit of a way to go yet, girl.
So
how's this render dried, this lime?
Oh, it's beautiful.
Ooh, yeah. Isn't it just?
Quite amazing.
Tell you what,
actually.
I like that sharp edge.
Yeah.
This is very smooth.
Yeah,
it's good,
exactly,
isn't it?
And
light in colour.
Yeah, it's a lovely colour. I mean, we experimented quite a bit, you know, and we didn't want pure white.
Yeah, well, it'll dry back, I guess, more, because it still feels a little damp. I mean, you would not know, would you, that this was a car tile?
Yeah.
You just would not know.
Because it is really, really bumpy.
Could be masonry.
This.
It could be masonry, it could be straw bale, it could be... But it's extremely solid. So I think it's a really good idea to have one bit of the project, this bit here, which is it's far in advance of what's going on out there. You know, I mean, you can come in here and you can get some inspiration. This is going to look really quite smooth and sharp. Providing you don't put too many of these little hobbit holes in, you know.
In South America, these are called nichos, and people.
Well, that's funny because over here they're called niches.
And they put their religious little figures in there as part of, you know.
But I'm not South American. Neither are you. What are they doing here? I don't understand them.
They're for candles.
So you put the candle inside the niche to light the niche and not the room.
Yeah. No, just to.
A little shelf and then put the candle on the shelf. That's...
Because we didn't want things coming out the walls. Because I think this room's probably going to be quite empty, mostly.
Okay.
It's not going to have too much stuff in it.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Fair enough.
I may be a bit dismissive about some of the finer design details, but I do admire both Daron and AD's drive. In just 3 months, they've managed to complete the structure, as well as teaching themselves new skills on the way. And now Daron's back from his roofing course in England, and he's installing the waterproof membrane.
OK, so we need the blowtorch, at least the blowtorch, and a little roller, heat-resistant roller. That is actually the key tool. This creates the heat, and this does the work.
Mmm. It's quite slow, isn't it?
Yeah, it is quite slow.
I mean, I know you're just starting, and I'm sure you'll speed up.
No, you can't. You've got to let it warm up, so you can't actually go much faster than this.
Really?
No.
Because this is a very large roof to do.
One person with a 2-inch roller might slow things down a bit, but I've a slightly bigger concern. I'm not sure how well the flat roof looks next to the beautiful slated cone.
Don't you feel that if you design this thing, you might have designed something a little bit more complex, a little bit more, a little bit better synthesized. That these rooms might have worked better together.
Apparently, one of the hardest things to do with a single-story earth-sheltered dwelling is to integrate a square and a round module. And this has just worked like an absolute dream. So we've been fortunate.
But I'm not convinced. I can't help feeling that for all of Daron's techno-speak of single-story earth-sheltered dwellings and modules, he may be missing the point. For him, it seems the joy is in the ecology and the construction. I just hope it's not at the expense of the look, the feel of the finished house.
You see, the hard question here is the aesthetic one, isn't it? The car tyres, when they're rendered with lime, they look delightful. That cone roof with those hand-cut tiles is also a delight, but does that mean that the overall project is going to be beautiful or not? And I ask that question because this house takes so many of its ideas from earthships. And the trouble with earthships, I think, is that so many of them are just so darned ugly, eh?
The low-tech approach does have its benefits. So far, it's enabled Daron to use voluntary, unskilled labour. But now he needs to take on some skilled trades. A local electrician has been brought in to fathom the 4 kilometres of wiring needed to meet French specifications. Outside, a local stonemason takes on the front walls. And Daron takes a break from the roofing to crack on boarding out the shell.
We've got all the structure of the roof done. We're basically pretty much waterproof now.
Meanwhile, AD and Sean are being creative, recycling coloured glass bottles to build a sort of reclaimed stained glass wall.